So we just watched the Scream TV show that MTV did.
Why have you done this to me? Why? Now I must destroy you.
There can be no forgiveness.
We're a little calmer now. Yeah, a little calmer. Hi, I'm the Horror Guru, and this is Count Jacula.
Yep.
And
that's me.
All
right, you see what these are? These are balls. Balls in your face. Big, round, difficult to get around, balls in your face.
I have no idea where to begin with this, because It's Dawson's Scream. Like, I got...
Yeah.
And I say that not just because it is is Scream done as a teen drama TV show, but because Kevin Williamson made both Scream and Dawson's Creek, and this is his newest creation, which is a combination of both ideas, except this time with super rich people.
Oh, yeah. Like, you think, like, the kids in fucking Scream are rich? All right, you know that, like, the opening kill with, like, Drew Barrymore and shit? Like, how rich that girl is? That is how rich all these kids are.
Even beyond that.
Oh, yeah.
Way beyond that. Like Drew Barrymore, she had a nice house. But that is an average nice house in a suburban neighborhood. This is beyond that.
Yeah. It's really... So, if you want Pretty Little Liars, Dawson's Scream, I guess you'll like this.
Yeah, this is definitely not intended for someone like me.
Oh, no.
This is not intended for fans of the original movies either.
Not even close.
No.
Not even close. Someone basically told people, hey, there are a lot of female fans of The Walking Dead and Supernatural, so let's capitalize on that audience while doing the really, really fucking stupid, and I mean stupid fucking teen drama bullshit. Like, that's what's cranked up to 11 here. It's not, there is blood, there is gore, but, like, more importantly that, there is teen drama cranked up to, like, fucking 12. And if you're like, wow, that sounds irritating, it is irritating. We spent a fucking hour with those characters. I don't know who anyone's fucking name is.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's like, all right, there's James Scream, like this one really good looking like horror fan.
Yeah.
You know, James, I'm just gonna call him James Scream because you came up with that.
Yeah, the new kid in town who's the rebel without a cause.
Who is somehow the fucking son of the sheriff. I'm like, and it's a sheriff who has been around, obviously.
Yeah, and you're like,
how is he the new guy? How is he the new guy?
Well, that could be easily explained that he used to live with the mom or something somewhere else.
Like, oh, okay. Well, that could all right.
Yeah, I've seen enough teen dramas. That's exactly what happened to you.
Okay. All right. I can let that one go then.
I guarantee that's what they're going to do. But that doesn't explain why, even though they straight up explain it, they have this whole backstory with this one, I guess, mongoloid-looking guy who was obsessed over this one girl in high school and then went on a killing spree because a bunch of jocks made fun of him and beat him up and then was shot trying to give her an amulet in...
Giving her, like, a Valentine.
Yeah. At this lake. And no one knows who the girl who was obsessing over was. And I'm like... Wait, if it's that girl, if it's that mom who lives in this town, does everyone...
they tell you who it is, straight up. And three times they tell you.
In this small town, how do they not know who it is? Like, even if they kept it from the newspaper, it's a small town. Like,
yeah, people would know.
People would know who got beat up at school. Like, the entire town would know. Like,
yeah, be like, oh, her. Like, those people are obviously still in town.
Yeah.
You know, like, why wouldn't they know it was her when, like...
It made no sense. They're like, oh, kept it from the newspapers. That doesn't make sense. Like, It's a small town. They would know.
Yeah, it wasn't like she moved away and then moved back. It's mm-hmm. like they've been there.
Mm-hmm. So,
you know, she's the county coroner.
Yeah.
You know, like, somebody fucking knows. The sheriff knew. You know, like, so the idea that this would just be forgotten is like, that's bullshit.
Yeah.
Everyone would fucking know. The only way this would make sense is if that girl had left town and she didn't. There are a bunch of characters in this.
Yeah.
I don't know who any of them are. There's lesbian, main character girl.
And that's her only character
trait. Yeah, her only character
trait. She's lesbian Daria.
Yeah.
Yeah. Which, I hate Daria, so that's like points against her.
Yeah, and she's the most sympathetic character.
I know.
And she's the most sympathetic character. And you still don't care.
Yeah, yeah. And they even have this whole monologue of how you have to care about the characters so that when they die, you feel bad. And I'm like, well, he did a terrible job of that.
Yeah, no shit.
Everyone like, here is fucking annoying.
Yeah, you're just sort of like, look, we all know you're just here to rack up the body count. The problem is any fucking possible problem that you could have with a slasher TV show, they point out because they have the Randy character, who I forget what his actual name is, but it's Randy. That's who it's supposed to fucking be. You know, explain why it's a bad idea. But by the episode, you're like, but he's right. It is a bad idea. You just proved it was a bad idea. Wow. It's like, hey, let's set off criticism at the pass. But it's right. He's right. It's a bad idea. Yeah. Like, the only thing that could have happened that would made me go, hey, I'm going to keep watching this show, is if the end of the first episode, they just kill all the kids.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
In a 1 minute bloody montage of slaughter, just dead, 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 dead. Everyone you thought was going to be the main character, dead. Fucking dead. At that point, I would have been like, I am tuning in next week because I don't know what's going to happen. But right now, this looks like this is going to go down exactly the way you think it's going to go down. Like, if you had, like, a problem with, like, how much... Like, I know there are a lot of people who like Bates Motel, but you cannot deny that sometimes they stretch that shit out a little thin. Sure. You know, so if that's a problem you have with that show, I guarantee you're going to hate this show more.
Yeah.
Then you're frustrated with that. Because unlike Bates Motel, which seems like it's a good show with a problem, this is a terrible premise.
Yeah.
The Scream TV show looks like it's just going to be bad.
You know, yeah. Like I said, when they first introduced all the characters in that one swoop, I'm just sitting there going, yeah, the big problem is I don't like anybody. And unlike a slasher movie, I know it's going to take fucking forever for them all to die.
Yeah, and you just don't want to spend that much time with them.
No.
Like, it's been 45 minutes. I'm already like, something happened. And the funny thing was, is you were predicting, okay, we're going to get a kill at the beginning, and then we're going to get a kill at the end, and like, that's going to
be because that's how Harper's Island worked, and it worked well for that. No.
No, there's only the kill at the beginning. And you're like, okay. And then main character chick, like, gets a call, like, oh, I'm watching you. And you're like, I don't fucking care. Something happened.
They waited till the very end to have the Scream voice, and oh, whoa.
Oh, God, the Scream voice, their version of the Scream mask?
All of it sucks.
It's all bad.
And their attempts to try to make it set in the modern day to where... With Scream, what they did with telephones, making telephones really, really terrifying. They try to do that with, like, internet harassment and things like that.
Yeah, they try to do that with, like, YouTube.
It feels really forced.
Oh, God, it's really forced. You can't. I'm sorry. It's like
Chirper.
Chirper. It's not Tweet. It's not Twitter. It's Chirper.
That hurt me.
Oh, God. What was their YouTube excuse?
I can't remember what they
called. And the thing that's like really irritating about this is I'm watching this video on MTV's YouTube channel and they've got a fake YouTube in the fucking show. And I'm like, could you just not get them to okay that? Really, MTV? Fucking. If, oh, man, like, all right, This is another one. You know how, like, they... Oh, God. Okay, like... Okay, so Unfriended. Another movie that I wasn't too crazy about. But everything I hate that was bad about Unfriended is in this show. Where you're just sort of like, technology is not only magical to a degree that your core audience knows it's not. Because they use it constantly. They know how this works. You know, so you're already going to kind of lose them because you're like, YouTube videos don't upload that fast. Vines don't upload that fast. You know, like, because one of the things that happens at the beginning is there's a guy putting videos that they are making of this one girl, uploading the YouTube and then texting her with the link so she could see that she's being stalked. But it's happening within seconds. Not like minutes, not like an hour, but like seconds. And you're like, nothing uploads that fast.
A Vine might.
Yeah, well, okay, yeah, okay, maybe.
A couple second Vine, which is basically what that was, might, but...
Yeah, but it felt like it was... They did it like three or four times. I was like, the first time it was kind of cool, because I was like, all right, I'll buy that.
Mm-hmm.
But then when it kept happening, you're like, all right, now this is starting to get annoying. And one of the things that happened is the girl gets killed in the beginning. In the beginning, she's talking to, like, her boyfriend who helped her set up the viral video that outed this one girl as a lesbian.
Which I don't think that girl needed to be outed. Like, she's just,
yeah,
they dressed her to basically be like, this girl's a lesbian.
Yeah, no shit. No shit. Like, fucking shirt.
Right down to the pixie cut.
Yeah, fucking butchy pixie cut. Fucking flannel.
Yeah.
Fucking, you know, black pants and boots with flannel. And I'm like,
it's one of those,
nothing about her doesn't scream lesbian.
Yeah, like I would be shocked if she wasn't already getting made fun of with the word lesbian.
Yeah,
like,
no kidding. Like, no kidding. It's like, oh,
because that's what teens do. Like, even if you aren't, like, if you look like it, they will go after you.
Yeah.
So I don't I was confused why it took a video for that to happen for her.
Yeah. Yeah, and so, like, so the mean girl who dies at the beginning, like, set this up with, like, this viral video up with her boyfriend, and, God, and so fucking, I don't know, like, she goes into her house, and then it's like her, the guy she was just with is, like, the one doing the stalking, so she gets a little into it.
Mm-hmm.
Then this one thing happens, which was actually kind of cool for the scene, but then...
Heads up,
and the dude's head falls into her
pool.
That
was the moment where I thought I might actually end up liking the show.
Yeah, 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 yeah. That was the moment where I was like, we might have something.
The entire first intro, the entire first kill scene, which is obviously a take on the Drew Barrymore scene in the original movie.
Yeah.
The technology thing felt very, 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 very forced, but the comedy was hitting.
Yes.
You know, so I was laughing and the kill was kind of cool. It was like, okay, awesome. It all goes downhill after that.
Yeah, yeah, it goes way downhill after that. And the thing is when the police are investigating the murder, the initial murder, they're all like, well, where's her boyfriend? And if you've been watching the episode, you're like, where did his head go?
Yeah.
Why is his head not part of the investigation? And that's the kind of thing where you're like, well, maybe that's part of the mystery. Maybe someone took the head back? And you're like, all right. But then the movie never... Oh, sorry, not even the movie. But then the episode doesn't do anything to indicate that that's the mm-hmm. case. And maybe in future episodes they go into that.
It's entirely possible.
Yeah, yeah, it's entirely possible.
Like, but the head might end up in someone's, like, fucking, like, fridge or something.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, they like, open up, happen. Like in Friday Part 2.
Yeah, like, that could totally happen. But at that point, you're just sort of like, what? it's like they brought up a problem that, like, they unnecessarily... make it look like the cops are looking for this guy, but they're also accusing people who just know a lot about initial series of legendary murders. And you're like, what do you have connecting this kid to those original murders? He doesn't even look old enough to have been alive when they happened. It's like, well, is he a copycat? Well, this What you could, you should have, you needed to connect that. He needed to have the same kind of knife, or he needed to be like a guy that carved wooden hearts or something. So that,
like, I think the idea was supposed to be, because that kid is very open about his obsession with serial killers, he was like suspect number one. Just as
yeah.
Which, once again, small town actually kind of makes sense, but then they do stuff that makes it sound like it's in a big town. So
yeah, so you don't know what the fuck is happening. So this ain't Scream. This is like Rich Kids Die.
Super rich. There was a point where I fucking hissed at the goddamn screen because she goes into her garage in what felt like it was going to be a setup for the or it might still be a setup for the garage scene that happens to fucking what's her name?
Yeah, but the one where she's killed in
Rose McGowan in Scream 1. It felt like a setup for that, so they'll probably have that happen later or something to that effect.
Yeah.
And they go into her garage, and she's got three expensive sports cars and a garage that can fit all three. That's how rich these kids are in this show. Holy shit. What the fuck? It's not Beverly Hills 90210. What?
Yeah, yeah, this is it's like Scream. Obscenely what the fuck? Rich. This is obscenely rich. God.
Oh, like, to the point God. Where it was actually getting in the way of me actually liking the characters, because I'm just like, oh my God, rich white girl problems. Like,
yeah. And they try to do that thing, too, where they, like, try to... There's a lot of attempts right now in television and movies to, like, you know, try to connect with, like, you know, like, the Tumblr crowd. Oh my God, do they do that. Oh my God, do they do that. Like, I just want to talk about my feelings. Shut up.
Well, that's not the Tumblr crowd. That's every teen show ever.
Oh, all right. Yeah, good point.
That's every teen show.
Yeah, but it felt like, oh, come on. I thought this was supposed to be Scream. I get that it's supposed to be those two things together, but we curbed that a little bit.
Yeah, well, it's the big problem. They even explain, like, oh, in order to do... They even have this whole monologue about how in order to do a slasher movie as a TV show, you have to stretch things out because TV has to stretch it out.
Yeah.
And so what do they choose to stretch out? Not the stalking, not the killing, not the mystery. They choose to stretch out those conversations in the Scream movies where the teenagers are gathered together talking about the kills that just happened. But in this case, it's one kill. They talk about the whole fucking episode, and you're just like, oh my God, something else happened.
Like, yeah, like something else happened. And also, there are a lot of things that would have worked had they actually... I don't know, set them up. Because, like, all right, they have the big party. You know, that happens at the end of the first Scream. They have the big party. And one of the guys passes out. And then the next thing you know, that guy is by the lake where the fucking Mongoloid killer fell in.
And you feel like something was missing there. Like
yeah, and you quickly figure out, oh, they just put him there because he passed out. But for a good,
it
like...
It feels like there's a scene missing. Of
yeah,
them, like...
yeah. It actually feels like something's missing. You know, because there's no, like, you know, shot of, like, a guy coming in just going, like,
we're going to do something. We're gonna do something. Are they going to do? They don't do anything like that. He just wakes up there, and you're just like, wait, what happened?
Yeah.
It takes a moment to disorient, and you shouldn't, like...
Yeah, you shouldn't... We shouldn't be confused as to why things are happening.
It also doesn't help that because it's a teen show, a lot of the handsome people look very similar at times.
Oh, yeah.
Like, the two blonde girls, I got mixed up a lot.
Yeah.
There's three blonde girls. There was the one at the beginning. There is the one who I guess is supposed to be Sydney.
I kind of miss Sydney. Yeah.
There's the one that has the three cars and the black eyebrows, and that's the only way I can differentiate her from the other two. Is cause she has
one
the
girl
black
has
eyebrows.
Big black eyebrows, and you're like, and she's like the hot richer chick.
It was like it's. It's like, you know, that racist joke that, like, people in China all look the same. Like rich white girls in the show all look the same.
Yeah,
to
they
me.
Do. They do. Because there's, like, there's lesbian girl, and then there's everybody else visually.
Yeah.
And, like, the main girl's a little bit different, but she's just sort of, like, white.
There was, like,
light.
Three different scenes with her where I thought she was three different characters, and I didn't realize it was the same character until, fourth scene.
Yeah, well, her skirt was just a little bit longer than theirs, you know, like, that's the tip-off.
And I'm constantly trying to figure out, like, this group of friends I don't understand. I got the group of friends in the Scream movie. Like even though they're not the nicest to each other, you kind of got their dynamic. I'm watching this, and I'm just going, why is the nice prissy girl like friends with the asshole jocks that like hate lesbians? Like, I just,
yeah, you don't get it.
What's going on here? This doesn't feel
well. I remember like there was this point where like they're in shop class and two of the jockey guys are like, "Did you get rid of that fucking video you took?" And he's like, "Yeah, I'll erase it eventually." He's like, "I'm not fooling around. I don't want to go to jail." And you're like, "What? If you took the video, the video's already public."
Yeah, yeah.
Why does it matter? The most they're gonna do is be like, "Well, you did the initial video.
It already went viral."
Of the girl who wasn't murdered.
Yeah, yeah.
Not of the girl who was murdered, because at that point you're like, "What?"
Yeah.
Maybe, I don't know. It's like one of those setups, but because it's a show within the episode, they didn't give you the reason to care.
Mm-hmm.
But you're like, "Oh, well, they'll care later." And I'm like, no, we need to care now. We need to care now because, like, we're already walking in at, like, a deficit because it's a Scream television series done by MTV.
Yeah, yeah. And oh my God, does MTV want you to know that they did this? Like that moment where that girl walked into her house and just immediately turned on like rap song, and I'm just like, oh my God,
yeah,
this
yeah,
feels MTV.
Yeah, it's like whatever like girl rap song is like popular, and I just stick that in.
That one girl in the beginning, she had like a gigantic pool and like two jacuzzis. Like,
yeah,
I was like, what the fuck?
Yeah,
I can't get over this. It's like, I don't mind there being shows about rich people or movies about rich people, but what I liked about Scream 1 was that it was basically anywhere America, like that small town could have been anywhere. It happened to take place in California, but that suburban neighborhoods could have taken place in fucking like Wyoming or something.
Well, yeah, it's supposed to feel like a little bit like Halloween, like Haddonfield, Illinois, even though we're in Southern California.
But in this, like, it could only take place in Southern California. Yeah, it could only
take place in sunny California, probably some rich suburb of L.A.
Yeah.
You know, and you're just like, really?
Really rich. Like 90210 rich.
Yeah. Yeah. God. So, look. About the only thing, I don't know what to say, because like the one good thing I've heard about this show is that the director Ty West is going to be directing a couple episodes, and maybe I'll check those out.
I probably will.
We'll yeah, see. Yeah, maybe I'll check those out. But for if you're a Scream fan, just avoid.
Yeah,
just
yeah.
Fucking avoid this.
As Scream fans, this really isn't for us.
Oh yeah, no.
This is clearly intended for the teen demographic of people who may have heard of Scream but not actually watched it. So this will be their Scream. And
It really wants to be.
I've seen a lot of like teen shows, stuff like Gilmore Girls or the 90210 remake. I've watched some of those. This is bad even by those standards.
Oh God, yeah.
And those shows, yeah. And a lot of those shows, well,
like, even
Girls
if you even
good.
If you like those, like, you know, teen girl drama shows, like, I don't think this is going to fit.
This
the
is
bill.
Bad even by those standards. Like, the acting is awful. Like, the drama is so cookie cutter by the numbers. Like, oh, there's a James Dean-esque character who shows up from out of town. Oh no, his dad is into my mom. Oh no, like that's like the same plot you can find in every teen show ever made.
Yeah, and it makes no indication that it's gonna fuck with that.
You know, oh,
no indication.
Oh, the two girls, like one became pretty and popular and the other one was not pretty, so she didn't remain popular, and so now she's bitter about the pretty and popular girl that used to be friends with her. Like, it's the same
thing
that happens in every goddamn teen show, but done so in your face by the numbers. And
yeah, because it's not even like, this isn't like, hey, they're playing with those tropes. They're doing like it's like, oh, you've got the jock, the slut, the you know, the survivor girl, and like the
and
stoner.
The funny thing is, even the fucking original Scream didn't do that.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Like, so like by this point in Scream, we had already fucked with the formula.
Yeah.
But they are just going by the numbers with this fucking bullshit for an hour. You know, like,
it's so great. Our main characters are the popular kids who make fun of this poor lesbian girl for having a relationship with a woman and virally shamed her. And these are our main characters. These are...
Yeah, it's like if the main characters from, like, I Know What You Did Last Summer were in Scream as a teen drama. But the problem is that what worked about I Know What You Did Last Summer, and it barely worked, let's be honest, is that that death count starts, and it just goes. By this point, like, we had killed, like, four people.
I might have been more interested in this goddamn show if, like, more people died in this
episode. Yeah, exactly. Like I said, like, if they had ended that first episode with all of the characters being slaughtered, at that point you would have been like, oh my god, I have no idea what's gonna happen. I gotta tune in next week.
Or at least if it had some more of the humor that was present in that first opening scene.
Yeah.
Like, just like...
Yeah.
Like, it's just, like, the first opening scene made me feel like we're, okay, this isn't just gonna be a teen drama with slashing killing. It's also gonna be a bit of a comedy. But after that, the comedy becomes very fucking sparse, and it really misses a lot.
Yeah. Yeah. Everything, most of the things that could have been funny are just, like, they're just groan-worthy.
Oh, and the self-aware fucking, like, oh, we're gonna talk about what we're doing as it's happening thing on this. Whoa. Way more forced than any of the Scream movies.
Oh god.
Even the ones I don't like.
yeah, it's super forced. It's like, well, we gotta have this, so we're putting it in. And the problem is you're like, you can't make a comment. You can't make a meta comment about the fucking formula while you're following the formula to the fucking T. It doesn't work.
Also, in terms of storylines that are in every fucking teen show ever, you have the pretty blonde girl who's fucking the teacher.
Yeah.
And the teacher wanting to end it, but the blonde girl not wanting to. Like, every fucking teen show.
Yeah, it's just everything. And yeah, I know that there's some of you going to be like, well, maybe they're going to fuck with that. I am predicting they're not going to fuck with that.
They didn't fuck with it enough with this.
Yeah.
Just pointing out that they're doing it was not enough to fuck with it.
Yeah.
Oh, boy. This is not very good.
This is bad. Avoid, do not watch, fucking zero stars.
I have a feeling this is not going to last a season. Oh, I do not think this is going to catch on.
No.
Like, this is not going to be the new Pretty Little Liars teen show about killing people that is going to...
Yeah, there's
sweep
not...
the nation. It's not going to do that. I guarantee it's not.
Yeah,
This was way too bad.
Yeah, there's nothing to latch onto here. Like, there's just nothing. So.
No character, with the exception of maybe the lesbian character, stuck with me. But even then, the only character trait I even fucking remember is lesbian.
Yeah, lesbian, short black hair.
Yeah.
It's the only way you can identify her. There is, like an Asian girl character who I'm like, this character could be interesting, but I'm not going to launch a show like this just for one character.
Yeah.
You know, who's obviously going to be like a side character that we don't see all the time.
It's entirely possible they might give her more to do later on, but I don't know if I want to wait around for that.
Yeah, you're going to have to, like, they're going to have to pull some big stunt.
Oh, I fucking hate the Randy guy.
Oh my God.
That guy is not, like, Randy was fucking endearing. You liked him. And a lot of horror fans watching those movies were like, man, that guy kind of is me. You cannot do that with this guy. This guy is presented as Mr. IQ 100 billion fucking intelligent, super smart.
Yeah. Gonna go into the space program smart.
I'm a nerd, but I'm clearly an Abercrombie model guy. Like, yeah. I hated that guy. And he was obnoxious.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. Pretty fucking bad. Ugh. Well, I think that's about it, Fright Night. So, in conclusion, is bad. Do not watch. Zero stars. Fuck this show.